Now, a newborn baby girl abandoned, just 3 hours old, her umbilical cord still attached. She was discovered in the backyard of a Blacktown home on Friday. She's now being cared for at Blacktown Hospital. Detectives are scouring CCTV footage to try and locate her mother. There's concern for her health and well-being. And joining me now to discuss this is psychologist Dr. Sandy Ray. Sandy, thank you very much for your time. Now, everyone is very worried about this little baby's mum. The baby's been cared for in hospital. This is a very vulnerable time for mothers when you've just had a baby. But look, I want to ask you as a psychologist, what is the profile of a mother who is so desperate that she would abandon her newborn baby like this?
Well, I think there's going to be one typical profile, and I think I can point to 100 reasons why a mother may abandon the baby. And we only have to look, first of all, at conception. How was the baby conceived? Is it a baby out of rape? Is it a baby created out of incest? Is it a baby created out of violence? Let's also not assume that the mother is just some wayward teenager. It could well be a married woman or a woman in a long-term relationship with other children and who really can't cope with the idea of having another baby. Maybe this woman didn't have access to termination, didn't understand how their baby could be terminated up to, I think it's 23 weeks and 6 days in Australia. Maybe the mother has a drug addiction or mental illness that's either diagnosed or not looked after. Maybe there was a neurodevelopmental disorder sitting within the mother. Maybe there were cultural reasons. So there's just an abundance of reasons why this poor woman felt that she was unable to do anything than abandon the baby.
I mean, babies physically and emotionally need their mums, and they, you know, you would hope that every baby born in this country is going to have a loving upbringing. What's the best way now for this newborn to have a good upbringing and a good chance at succeeding in life?
Well, what I've read in the statistics, Sharri, is there's about 10 abandoned babies a year that occur in Australia. And of course, we have a very, very good and secure and safe adoption agency and system. I would imagine that the baby is going to be well loved, well nourished, well looked after in an appropriately screened environment, you know, going on to an appropriate family. But of course, when you read some of the literature of some of the children who've either been adopted or who have been abandoned, some of them yearn for their genetic, you know, mirror. They don't have a genetic mirror. They feel lost. They don't know. They don't look like the other members of their family. They don't think in the other ways of the family. They don't have a medical history or even a history, a developmental history. What is the genealogy of my family? So there are many very successful adoptions, but there are also some who are just plagued with loss and grief and not having who is my real family.
It's such a sad case, such a sad circumstance. Just the thought of that newborn baby being left in a backyard, you know, its umbilical cord not even cut, just crying without any food. It's really, really devastating. I hope the government is able to find that a happy home.
It is devastating. Yeah, I agree. Thank you, Sharri.
All right, Sandy Ray, thank you very much for your insights.